You! Do you know what a dining philosopher's problem is? It's a problem related to algorithm design. I'll simplify things for you, okay? There are five philosophers sitting around a circular table, like so. Everyone's got a bowl of noodles, with one chopstick placed between each adjacent philosopher. The philosophers only do two things. They eat, and they think. In order to start eating, they'll have to hold both left and right chopsticks. Everyone needs two chopsticks to eat, right? It's that simple. So, what's the problem? Here's a situation. What if they were all simultaneously hungry? Philosopher A makes a grab for the left chopstick, but by the time he's reaching for the right, everyone's already done the same thing. Do you see the situation here? Everyone has one chopstick, which isn't enough. So they're just kind of forever stuck awkwardly waiting now, which isn't the most ideal situation to be in. In fancy algorithm terms, this is called the deadlock, as well as resource starvation. Everyone just starves waiting for their turn. So, what's the solution? How about we introduce a monitor to the situation? Like, let's say, an angry mother, who monitors and gets to decide what these philosophers do. She'll set down a rule, which is to ask for her permission to eat. Philosopher A starts by asking, "Mother, can I eat?" So the mother responds, "Sure, go ahead and try." So A tries, succeeds in getting both sides, and eats. "Mother, how about me? Can I eat?" Philosopher B goes, so mother says, "Go ahead and try." She tries to pick up the chopsticks, only to find out one side is missing. "Never mind then," B says, and sets them back down. The same situation goes for C, who succeeds in getting two. D asks for permission to try, fails, and so does E, who asks and fails. So those who fail have to wait for the next round to try again. This is a good enough solution as it is, where at least not everyone's stuck waiting. But let's say, on the second round, Philosopher A asks for permission again before the ones who were waiting earlier get the chance to. It's not fair, isn't it? How about we add priority scheduling too? Priority scheduling can be set by the amount of time spent waiting to eat. The longer the time spent waiting, the higher the priority. In the second round, Philosopher B was stuck waiting the longest, so he gets to try first, then C, then D, so on and so forth. That's all there is to it. Hope it makes sense. Thanks for tuning in.